Good Monday morning, everybody. Live and direct from House Onek, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek, keeping an eye on what the weather is going to be doing as we go into the rest of the day today. It looks like it's going to be hot. It looks like it's going to be humid. And unfortunately, it's going to be that way for about the next couple of days. We'll be taking a look at the complete forecast coming up here in just a little bit. Currently, at this point, we've got little, if anything, going on in the way of major problems. We may be looking at more possibilities of thunderstorms coming our way as we get into the course of the rest of the day today. We'll talk more about that as well. If you got any questions about the forecast, we are live on Periscope and Twitter for this morning. Give me just 1 second here while I check to see if everything is working properly. And it looks like it is at this point, so we're doing pretty well on that. Again, pretty clear across the Mid-South for this morning, definitely hazy out across the area, and more than likely going to be staying that way. Hopefully not enough to, again, do anything in the way of major amounts of problems for outdoor activities. But if the kids are going to be out there, again, you're going to want to make certain that everybody is staying safe with the hydration out there. Make certain everybody is not going to be overheated. It's going to be one of those types of days out there to make certain that you are able to keep track of stuff like that into and around the Mid-South area. Very hot, very humid out there, and that could be, again, a bit of a problem. Pardon me for just a second while we get all of our Facebook viewers into here. And looks like the signal is doing pretty well on there as well. So triple threat, here we go. Again, we are live on Periscope, Facebook, and Twitter at the top of the hour, and things are looking pretty good out there for right now. We're not seeing too much in the way of rainfall or anything else taking place at this time. Current forecast, again, right here in the blue bar. Website, WREG.com/weather right here, and also our social media pages here and over in that graphic right here. Email, if there's something you'd like to see on these weather overtime reports. Report so far. This is something that, again, you can take and find out more about what's happening. Losing my Facebook signal here for just a little bit, so stay tuned for just a moment and I'll get all that taken care of. In the meantime, if you are just joining us, again, we have the possibility of seeing a few showers and thunderstorms out across the Mid-South area, and that is going to be a bit of a problem out there for, again, the later on during the rest of the day today. So if you have any plans for outdoors, this could be, again, something to take a look at. Again, for later on for today, this is going to be something, again, that we see for the rest of the day today that could be a bit of a problem, but fortunately not too much to worry about, at least at this time. We're going to have to, it looks like, let's see, switch over here real quick. This is live netcasting here. It's something not entirely akin to what we have during a regular newscast. So this is something that is pretty much normal out there. We're trying to get our Facebook viewers back again, and we're trying to get all this taken care of at this time. So unfortunately, let's go ahead, instead of mumbling on through, go ahead and show you what's going on out there for right now. St. Francis in Cordova, you've got a few clouds out around the horizon. Traffic is looking pretty good at this point in time. So if you have any, again, outdoor plans today, that is going to be the worst of our concerns so far. And we continue, again, to see the potential for more showers and thunderstorms out there for the rest of the day today. Now into, again, the rest of the day, we'll be looking for the possibility of more showers and thunderstorms later this week, which could be a bit of a problem and could be some severe weather out there as well. So stay tuned for more information on that. Again, give me just 1 second here. Amazing how well this works. I'm going to try this one more time. You would think that we would have everything taken care of with the tinfoil on the receivers. We are back live on Facebook right now, hopefully. If that does not work, we'll see what else happens here and let you know about that. Again, for this morning, looking at St. Francis in Cordova, the view along Germantown Parkway is doing quite nicely for right now. This is where I'm going to be a little bit later on, talking to the kids about eclipses and details about the weather and everything else going on. Got tons of stuff to talk about, and right on in through the eclipse itself. Hopefully going to begin getting, again, some pretty good weather coming on up through here for that. Let's go ahead and take a look at radar and see if we have anything out there. Welcome to everybody on Facebook. It looks like everything is starting to gel properly here for right now. We don't have much going on, again, so far in the Mid-South. What you're looking at is just tons of humidity up in the air, which is very easily detectable with, again, our technology today. We're just not seeing anything in the way of rainfall taking place. But according to the computer models, there is going to be a good possibility of some thunderstorms taking place. And unfortunately, that is going to be right around the time we see the eclipse. So that's something we're going to have to take a look at and make certain that we notice, especially with the kids out and about. So please use caution on that. What does it look like where it comes to anything involving the current situation with clouds? It's not all that bad, so good news on that. This is what is called a water vapor satellite imagery. Notice up around Chicago and into around the upper Midwest, got a large complex of thunderstorms firing up, and that is going to be giving them a lot of problems with visibility for later on. Hopefully that clears out there. Here in the Mid-South, we've got, again, dry air in the reddish colors on either side back toward Texas and Oklahoma. Very dry air slots here, here, and just to the south of us. We've got, again, some light areas of clouds, tons of moisture out there for those clouds, but nothing really popping up just yet, and hopefully things will remain on the clear side for later on. But we don't have anything in the way of major amounts of rainfall coming on through for right now. You can see that on wide-scale radar. Not that much going on. Again, a few showers and thunderstorms up into around the Texas and Oklahoma panhandles. Beyond that, not really that much happening, so very good news where we're concerned. If you'd like to see more of our WeatherBug cameras, again, they're out there and available for you at WREG.com/webcams. Bethel Springs, the Cotton Exchange camera, St. Francis camera, all available to you. So again, please drop by and take a look at that on our webcams page for more information. All right, let's time things out and show you what we've got going on. Again, through today, we've got, again, that possibility of a few stray showers and thunderstorms. Unfortunately, that kind of widens to a larger area, especially to the Mississippi River and back toward the west. That's going to be the best possibility of thunderstorms today into and around the area from southern Missouri down to northern Louisiana. That's where we will see, again, the possibility of the heaviest amounts of anything involving rain. Now, the chances of rain are not great. We'll take a look at percentage chances here in just a little while, so stay tuned for more on that. And then into the next couple of days, new cold front arrives as we head into tomorrow, and that into Tuesday night and Wednesday morning could give us the potential of some stronger weather, perhaps even some severe weather capabilities out there. We'll also take a look at that potential coming up here in just a little bit. If you're just joining us on Facebook, thanks a lot for stopping by. Please feel free to share our video cast and let everybody know what's going on out there. We do not at this time have a heat advisory in effect for the Mid-South, but it is going to be very hot and humid out there with temperatures on the heat index scale back into around 100 to 105 degrees today. And again, the possibility of strong to severe weather coming our way a little bit later on. Bozo Woolfolk from Senatobia, welcome to the show for this morning. Cindy Clark Johnson, welcome very much to the show. Thank you very much for the inspirational comments on there. Looking again into the rest of the day today, and again, timing things out where the eclipse is concerned, we should be seeing, again, temperatures for the rest of the day heading back into the lower to mid 90s. It could even be around 90 degrees by the time we hit eclipse time itself. And the chances of showers and thunderstorms, again, are not great. They're better than what they were last night, but we're seeing about a into the teens percent chance to around lower 20% chance for Shelby County. Higher percentage between the Mississippi River and Alabama, right into around north central areas of Mississippi, and also northeastern parts of Arkansas. That may be the best of the best taking place right there, with the potential of showers and thunderstorms highest into that area. Now, chances of rainfall, again, we're just not looking at huge amounts potential, but they are going to be there. What exactly are we looking at as we head into the forecast? This is the activity planner from the National Weather Service, which you can access. It's got tons of great weather information available, and the area we're looking at is right here on your screen in the red and green bars. This is what we're showing. Again, the potential for this, what you're looking at here, rain is in the green category. Lightning or thunder potential is right here for the possibility of seeing, again, thunderstorms developing. Now, because the bars are so small, the potential of getting anything really major out of this today is fairly low. This is if the bars were way up here, I'd be expecting the possibility of a lot more widespread areas of showers and thunderstorms. Notice that it starts happening right about the time we get into the major part of the eclipse today at about 1 o'clock and continues right on in through about News Channel 3 at 5 and Rush Hour Home. But the good news at this point is it's a minimal chance The problem is it's still a chance. So if you are outdoors with the kids today, you see lightning, you hear thunder, back indoors. Do not, again, risk your lives for just pictures of the eclipse if there's lightning out there. So please keep that in mind. But once again, we're just not looking at huge chances. And it looks like it'll be happening when the atmosphere is at its most unstable and through the rest of the day today. So this is what we're going to be watching for later on. This is going to be the best opportunity for anything happening out there in the form of showers and thunderstorms. And again, that heat index, please make certain all the kids are properly hydrated out there to make certain everything is okay. Into the tropics real quick. Again, this is sort of the minor story of the day. We have what's left of Tropical Storm Harvey on its way toward Nicaragua and back to around the east coast, around the area of Mexico and Belize. Not a threat to the United States. This one, though, around the Bahamas as it moves northwestward, could make its way across Florida in about the next couple of days, so this could be a bit of a problem. Another one farther out into the Atlantic, past the Windward Islands and into areas, again, between areas of South America and Africa. This is something we have to watch, too, but otherwise, we're not seeing anything major going on. More information about the forecast, about the eclipse, all kinds of great weather information and inspirational stuff, science and geekery. You can find that on my Facebook page if you're not there already at facebook.com/AustenOnek WREG. And also don't forget to follow along on my Twitter page. This will be very active a little bit later on as we keep you updated as to what's going on with the forecast into the rest of the day. That's twitter.com/AONIC_WREG3. And as of right now, again, this is going to be the great opportunity to see stuff. We have put more information about the eclipse on here, about what we're expecting to see with the sun's atmosphere. The sun does have an atmosphere, and we can study that, and we can study it a lot better when the moon is actually blocking the view. So it's a great opportunity to see more on this. Tons of weather information, again, available into my Facebook page, Twitter page, and all my other social media networks as well. Thank you very much, Susan Nix Finzo. Thank you very much for dropping on by. I appreciate the kind words there. And as of right now, again, we're looking pretty good conditions out across the Mid-South. Let's go back to radar for just a little bit. Let's see if the seven-day forecast is working. Yes, it is. Okay, for a Todd Demers forecast, 20% chance of shower or thunderstorm today. And again, temperatures back in the lower to mid-90s, 80s for later on this week, so that's looking a little bit better. But so far, nothing really major in the way of problems with overcast skies or tons of severe weather either. Radar is, again, not showing much of anything going on. Things are very quiet across much of the Mid-South. We're just not seeing any rainfall just yet, but it's a good possibility that this display will be active later on. Memphis metro area right in here in the center part of your screen. And what you're looking at on screen is just a lot of moisture hanging out several thousand feet up. We're chock full of moisture right now. We don't have that much in the way of cloud cover, thankfully, just yet, nor do we have that much in the way of rainfall. Do have a little bit of patchy fog out there, but that's about the main thing. So good news on that is we're just not seeing too much of anything right now. Want to know more about the forecast? Tune in to AM 730 Yahoo Sports Radio. Bob and Josh are on the air right now with Talkback Live and will be until 9 o'clock this morning. So tons of great weather information. Join me again as we go to St. Francis in Cordova to get a good idea as to what's going on. My kids are sleeping in and staying home for later on today and going to be, again, taking care of things here, but they will be catching the eclipse themselves later on while at home. So as of right now, if you'd like to see what's going on at St. Francis, keep it tuned to News Channel 3. We'll get special coverage throughout the entire day and especially right at the time of totality, and we'll be talking more about that coming up again later on News Channel 3. Thanks to everybody. David Howell, fog, a little bit of patchy fog out there this morning, not that much, not enough for a dense fog advisory, so definitely good news on that from the National Weather Service, but nothing to worry about at least so far. But some patchy dense fog may linger out there within about the next hour or so. Questions, concerns, comments, anything like that, the email address up in the blue bar on the screen at austin.onek@wreg.com. Would love to hear from you and find out more. We'll be hopefully going live later this morning from St. Francis to let everybody know what's going on, and we'll also keep you updated throughout the rest of the day, again, right here at this website, wreg.com/weather. Live and direct from House Onek, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Stay tuned for more with News Channel 3 throughout the rest of the day as we approach this historic solar eclipse.